Hey guys, it is me and today I'm going to show you how to install Music Box on Samsung Galaxy Note, because most of the Android root applications are requiring to check out the Music Box, just like another Android application that is going not also to ask you for root permission, it's also going to ask you for the root permission and the Music Box too. So another example is the Crazy application for ADB. An error, craze was caused, no music box MINI found. So this device is really rooted. Okay, this is rooted. But music box is not installed. It is the simple method installed by Ericsson. So I have on my folder instead. Why I cannot have 15 likes on YouTube? Who go higher at this one? Have what the fuck? Download Music Box. It can be installed any version, but Music Box can be still installed, but require root. Open the app. Grand. Welcome to Music Box. The custom version of Music Box is here, so So it's going simple to install the Music Box. Install. Music Box has been rooted, and as you can see, Music Box installed. Finally, the Music Box MINI, so you really require to root. After your device is rooted, you can install Music Box with this application by Ericsson. And another thing I say, also protect the root from your device with Vodo Water Root Keeper. How I like to say, first of all, I need to check for the Music Box, which I installed the root access, and the Music Box too. And this one is very interesting. So how to protect your root device, how to protect the sub-binary, because Vodo Water Root Keeper is supporting only the Samsung Galaxy Note 1 and Sony Xperia series. But I don't have any Android to test the Vodo Water Root Keeper. But it supports only the Sony Xperia U and Sony Xperia RE. But it also supports the Samsung Galaxy Note 1 and 7000. Open the app. Let's check this out. Protect root. Root sub protected. So temporarily unroot device unrooted with backup. So now my device is unrooted temporarily. So I can protect my device. Excuse me, the root doesn't support. So the installation can be success. Restore root. Yes, root to restored. Okay. Temporarily unroot means that your device will be untemporarily unrooted, but it can also restore the root, the sub-binary backup. Temporarily unroot, keep backup. Restore root. And that's alright. That was so far. Now you can run any application which is require root and BusyBox. So grand and this one is looking like an emulator, but this one is not really acting like an emulator. So the root access, the browse package, so I already show you how to install the BusyBox and protect the device root with Voodoo Auto Root Keeper. So I have now to update the time and date. Finally. So if doesn't work this method to update time and date with network, you can connect your device to USB, access the ADB data. USB debugger is required to be enabled, like that, and enable USB debugging, click yes, okay, and allow the device to be connected and put the useful commands for updated time and date, or use ADB tool like always I do. So instead, that is about this. Install BusyBox and protect the root copy of this Samsung Galaxy Note. But my problem is, I waste my time to find another Android for my collection. And the S Pen is missing. But I buy. But waste my time. You waste my life. You waste my time. You waste my Android. You waste my collection. Psh. But I rooted and installed BusyBox on that thing. So, if you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. If you really know what is really happening to me. If this thing will work to you, to install the BusyBox, to install the Root Keeper. But it's also for rooted users who are rooted already. So it's just fine. I already rooted BusyBox and protected Subbinary with Auto Root Keeper. So, thanks for watching.